Rig equipment inspection. Crown and traveling block. Figure 196, new Nove crown block fitted with automatic grease cartridges. Figure 197, modern Nove sheave cluster. Most rigs have 7 sheaves installed. Figure 198, example of the specifications of a modern crown block cluster made by Nove. Figure 199. Sheave bearing inspection by wobble test with a crowbar. Note, there must be no tension on the drill line and the traveling blocks need to be hung off. Figure 200 and figure 201. Groove radius and sheave gauges. The radiuses of the sheaves are measured with sheave gauges. For each type of sheave, the maximum wear is already incorporated in these gauges. For instance, the 1 3/8 sheave has a plus factor of 1/32 inch, expressing the maximum wear. Sheave measurements using the sheave gauges. Note, be aware that the loss of the upper layer of the hardened sheave profile can rapidly increase the wear of the sheave profiles, so that frequent inspections are required. Figure 205, single sheave. Some rigs use a single sheave for the fast line, as these wear faster than all the other sheaves. Also, changing the bearings on a single sheave is much easier than on a cluster of sheaves. Figure 206, sheave cluster. Depicted here is a sheave cluster with a set of automatic grease cartridges installed, which reduces the number of visits to the crown block platform for greasing purposes. Figure 207. Grease plug. Grease plugs need to be removed to energize the grease cartridges. Figure 208, grease cartridge. After energizing the grease cartridges, a chemical reaction inside the cartridges is slowly pushing the grease out. Figure 209, traveling block general layout. Figure 210, grease points of the traveling block. Traveling block maintenance. Two weekly maintenance routine. Although only being used intermittently, the traveling block must be lubricated using the OEM recommended program specified in the lubrication chart. 6 monthly maintenance routine. Gauge the sheaves of the traveling block. The sheaves should be reworked or replaced if the throat bottom radius falls below the recommendation in Section 3 of API RP9B, Application, Care and Use of Wire Rope for Oil Field Service. Yearly maintenance routine. Wash down all the dirty parts of the equipment and allow them to dry. Have the lifting appliance equipment inspected by a competent enterprise to verify that it is suitable for another year of operation. A signed copy of the inspection report must be filed in the maintenance log, and the remarks must be followed up. The yearly inspection must include a complete visual inspection and MPI by means of the wet fluorescent method, CAPI Spec 8C, of the following load-bearing components: critical areas of cheek plate, sheave shafts and critical areas of the sheaves. Touch up all the paint damages, but wait until the inspection by the competent enterprise has been carried out. 6 monthly inspections. Visual inspection of the wire sheaves with respect to wear, deformation and cracks. If there is any visible evidence of damage, carry out an MPI by means of the wet fluorescent method of the damaged, suspected areas. The sheave wear measurement and acceptance criteria must be according to the recommended practice described in the API RP9B standard. Inspections after jarring, top hole drilling. When the traveling block has been subject to impact loads, for instance during jarring or rough top hole drilling, it must be inspected with respect to cracks, loose bolts and parts, signs of overload and deformation. Listed below is a guideline for inspections after jarring, top hole drilling. Based on the actual operation carried out, the responsible for the operation must determine the required extent of inspection according to the amount of abuse and the level of impact loads to which the traveling block has been subjected. Inspect the sheave pin retainer plates, one retainer plate on each end of each sheave shaft, with respect to the loose bolts and parts. Damaged parts must be removed and taken out of service. After the equipment has been returned to service, it must be observed during its operation to verify an adequate performance. Figure 211. Overly designed jumper bars over the sheave cluster. Figure 212. The standard 3 tubes fitted over the sheaves is more than enough to prevent the drilling line jumping off the sheave. Figure 213. This rig had a new crown cluster fitted without jumper bars. Figure 214. Performing a wobble test, checking for poor, worn sheave bearings or cracked sheaves. The bar is a little too long. Figure 215. Performing a wobble test, checking for worn bearings or sheave bosses loose on the outer race and the inner race slack on the pin. One bar is a little long, the other simply ridiculous. Figure 216. One sheave just on the edge of the bearing. Total failure is looming, taken the day after raising the bop. Figure 217. Wear rate above the maximum allowable wear on the fast line sheave. Figure 218. Sheave gauge and checking sheave groves. Figure 219. Checking the sheaves with a sheave gauge. This so-called new sheave already shows too much wear on one side. This was a good paint job over a worn sheave, which then returned like this from the workshop. Figure 220. This sheave shows less indication of excessive wear. Figure 221. Cracked sheave on the crown cluster. Figure 221. Cracked sheave on the crown cluster. Figure 222. You don't need gauges to see these are worn. Both failures could have been avoided by regular inspections. This one lost the well. Figure 224. Approximately 90% of the sheaves are condemned after 5 years. The sheave profile is excessively worn or too soft. Or cracks are present as on this sheave parallel to the sheave profile. Figure 225. Install self-closing gates barriers at the crown block platform entrance. Figure 226. A very simple design for a self-closing gate. Figure 227. Bumper blocks protected by heavy-duty wire mesh. Note, this must be fitted with safety slings. Figure 228. Distinct wear pattern on the traveling block sheave covers a clear indication of a twisted drill line or an excessive fleet angle of the drill line coming from the drawworks drum. figure 229, long-term storage of the traveling block in a vertical position. The unauthorized welding used here to secure the block in the vertical position can actually cause severe damage on the bearing. Figure 230. Excessive play for the main shaft of the traveling block. It is no longer possible to grease, as the grease nipple is broken off, a so-called Dutchman. Figure 231. Measuring the sheaves and bearing condition by performing a wobble test on the traveling block, which is not an easy task. Figure 232. What is wrong in this yard? Figure 233. NDT inspection as per API RP 8B and ISO 13534. Figure 234. NDT inspection according to API RP 8B and ISO 13534. Crown block checklist. Traveling block checklist. Thank you.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.